Hello and welcome. Bill Skladowski here, and it's time for another edition of iPhone Friday. Thank you for joining. If you're watching us live here on Facebook, give it a thumbs up and feel free to share it with friends and colleagues who might find this interesting. And if you're watching on the blog or on YouTube, thanks for joining us as well. And if you have comments and questions, like we always said, feel free to leave them anywhere you're watching because I read and respond to all of them. Well, after a little bit of heavy-duty thinking, all right, it wasn't such heavy-duty, but I did put out the question a couple of weeks ago about how to move forward with our iPhone Fridays. And I put out the idea of basically teaching the same class here online that I do in the adult education program where I teach here in Southwest Florida. Kind of some mixed response to that. A couple of people said, yeah, cool. And I was all set to go for it. And then when I really got thinking about it, I'm like, that's not going to be easy to do because typically those classes are 2 hours long and I do them over a course of 3 or 4 weeks. So 2 times 4 weeks, 8 hours of classes. So obviously not going to do, 2 hours at a sitting here. I don't want to put you through that. I don't want to put myself through that. So I kind of modified it a little, and what I think I'm going to do is what I've put out on, if you saw the Facebook post earlier, iPhone A to Z. What does A to Z mean? Well, every week, every Friday, we're going to take the next letter, A, B, C, D, and we're going to dig into a little bit of something that has to do with that. So today, iPhone Friday, A is for Apple ID. What do you think? And then next week, who knows, we'll pick a B and we'll go from there. We'll pick a C and we'll go from there. I'm already thinking C is for calendar. That's one of my favorite and most important parts of the iPhone. But of course, some things are going to have a lot of possible things to go with the letter and some not so much. So we'll see how that goes. But for today, iPhone A to Z and A is for Apple ID. What do you think? If you don't think it's going to fly, well, let me know. And if you've got some ideas about it, let me know those too. But for now, let's dig in and talk Apple ID, shall we? And let's dig into the phone. And some of this stuff has been covered in previous videos, touched on a little bit here and there. But I'd like to do a little more deep dive into this to let you know some of the things that are going on. And as we do it, as we pick our individual topics, A, B, C, etc., I'm going to try to make it very like I would normally do in the classroom to do some of the basic stuff and then maybe a couple of tips and tricks as we go. All right. Whew, that's a big warm-up, wasn't it there? I appreciate you. Okay. So anyway, Apple ID, what is it? Well, if you don't know, whenever you have an Apple device of any kind, and by device, I mean anything from an iPhone to an iPad to a Mac computer. I did this because I'm recording this on my Mac computer. To an iWatch, any Apple device that you buy, you're going to get an Apple ID. Now, you only get one, so if you bought an iPhone 5 years ago and you bought a new iPhone this week or you bought a new Mac computer or something, it's the same one. It carries through, okay? And basically, an Apple ID is the email address that Apple uses to contact you anytime you do something with your device. And that could mean like buy an app or download something from Apple directly, like a free app, even that uses it. Or it has all sorts of other things attached to it. And we're going to dig into a few of those today. So now, by the way, you also have with, well, let's dig in and I'll get to that. Jump on over to settings over there. Same as always, our big gear. Now, settings are going to play a big part in a lot of what we talk about. And that's just the way it is. There's a lot that you can do with in the settings of your device, whether it's an iPhone or an iPad or a Mac or whatever. Of course, we're here to talk about iPhones. So let's dig into settings, shall we? And if you've followed along with the show for the past few weeks, you'll notice it's been a real ongoing joke between me and the iPhone as to whether or not my picture is going to be up there. So sometimes it is and sometimes it isn't. But if you can read it, right under my picture there, there's a little black underline and in the black section it says edit. Okay, so if you don't have your picture there but you'd like to have your picture there, all you have to do basically is tap on where it says edit and then it's going to offer you to either take a new picture or choose a photo out of your photo library, right? Or browse for it somewhere else. Like if you have a good photo on Facebook or whatever, you can do that. You know, most people though, it's going to be take a photo. So you're going to, you know, turn on the take photo, and then you have to use the selfie part of it. So you turn it around and there I am, and I can take my picture and all of that. So I'm not going to do that now, but you can take your picture and then it basically puts it inside a circle, and you can move that around and then just say, use this picture, and it will do that until it doesn't. I don't understand, but anyway, that's not a big deal. Let's move on. Under your name, you see there where I have my Gmail address, okay? And that is the Apple ID. And this is important, and it confuses a lot of folks. And that is your Apple ID can be any email address. Surprised? You won't be after the next exciting adventure of... No. Going back to my broadcasting roots there. So anyway, your email address can be anything. Mine is a Gmail address, all right? If you have no other email address, if you were to walk into an Apple store and say, I've never been online before, I have no email address, I have nothing, you will still have an email address that ends in iCloud.com. And you can see that, by the way, if you tap on that first line where it says name, phone numbers, and email. See that right there? And you tap on that, it's going to dig in and say, here you are, here's your name, and how you are reachable, right? And it even says, look, right there with Apple ID, it says Bill Sklodowsky, bskladowsky@gmail.com, Apple ID, all right? And then there's my phone number, and no, I don't care if you have it, because I don't talk to people that aren't in my contacts anyway. We talked about that a few weeks ago. And then there's other email addresses down there, and there's that iCloud address. So bskladowsky@icloud.com, right? So you're always, if all else fails, you are always going to have an iCloud email address, okay? But again, you can use any email address you want for your Apple ID, right? Now, here's an important fact that I think a lot of people miss, and that is if you use a different email address, something other than the iCloud account, if you use, like for me, I'm using my Gmail address as my Apple ID, okay? Just remember, and this is super important because I see people confusing it so often, just remember that the password is going to be different when you use it for Gmail on the Gmail webpage versus when you use it for the Apple ID on anything Apple related, okay? So same email address, different passwords, all right? So when you write them down or keep notes on them or whatever you do to make sure you know that when it's like when you're using it for iCloud, you know, I always have a little spreadsheet or something, you know, iCloud Apple ID /bskladowsky@gmail.com. Password. Now it's going to be different than the one when I log into Gmail. There you go. That's our first little time saver right there. Okay. So some other things on here. Now, if you are going to download, and so let's move on. I was going to say password security, by the way. That's some pretty simple stuff, okay? You can turn on some fancy things like two-factor authentication and some other fancy things. You can, the top there, if you want to change the password, you can do it right here, all right? No big deal. It's easy to do, all right? Not a whole lot to worry about with that one, with the password there. Only if you should forget your password, you can come in here and do it, all right? Payment and shipping options, all right? Now, this is going to be where you have things like what credit card you have on file with Apple. And this is another thing that I find confuses folks. And that is, why do I have to have a credit card on file if I'm not buying anything from Apple? Fair question, okay? And the answer to that is, Apple requires a credit card on file for you even if you're downloading only free apps, okay? So why is that? Well, I'm not 100% sure, but I suspect it's because Apple thinks someday you're gonna wanna buy something and we wanna have that credit card ready to use when you do. So anyway, if you are brand new to your device, I mean, if you've just gotten one or you haven't done that or you haven't downloaded any apps, okay, if you try, you're going to find out exactly what we said, all right? So that's where you would add that in. Now, the first time you do it, by the way, if you go to the App Store, and there's another whole A thing, App Store. Maybe we should have done that one too. it's going to prompt you for that the first time you go to do it. But after that, it's going to be saved in there. You know, it's not going to, you know, people always ask me, you know, could I, is it possible for me to buy something and not recognize it? Well, I suppose it is, but anytime you go to tap or click or download on an app that has a price, a cost involved, it's going to pop up something on your screen and say, hey, this is going to charge to your credit card. Tap here to continue, or use your finger ID or your face ID or something like that. So you really got to, I'm not going to say be careful with it. I'm just going to say Apple, the phone, will let you know when that's going to happen. Okay. So let's move along because I did want to cover a couple of other things. And to me, this one right down here, this iCloud, is one of the most important parts of this Apple ID setup. So let's jump in there. All right. Because this is where it shows how much storage you have in your iCloud account. Now, here's another important thing to keep in mind. Your phone has storage space on it, right? If you know your computer terminology, and it's not really high tech, but because we all have a computer, or we all have, you know, a laptop or something, all right, you know that the laptop or the computer has X amount of storage space on it, right? In what we would call the hard drive or the memory or the whatever, right? So, you know, my big Mac computer here has, you know, I think a terabyte of storage or something, some enormous amount of storage, because it has a hard drive inside and it stores stuff on it. You know, things when I like have documents and pictures and videos and, you know, all the stuff that I save and I create and all that stuff, it all gets stored on the computer, right? And it gets stored on the hard drive. Well, that's using that. Your phone is no different. It has storage space on it to store stuff. Say that fast 5 times. Space to store stuff. But this that we're looking at, this iCloud, is not on the phone. It's out there in the cloud. Yes, that you know, everywhere it's at, cloud kind of a thing. So when you buy a new device, when you get your phone or your watch or your iPad or whatever, you know, we already said you get an iCloud account. It just comes with it. And with that, you get 5 gigabytes of storage space. 5. Which, if you don't know, sounds like a lot. But if you've ever tried to take a picture with your phone or a video and it's popped up that message and said, sorry, out of storage space, you might think 5 gigabytes isn't so much after all. Okay, so what can you do? Well, Apple is, of course, happy to sell you more storage space, right? And as you can see over here where it says manage storage, right? If you need more space because you take a ton of pictures or you take a lot of videos, you know, or you just whatever are doing a lot of things with your phone, and a lot of people are, you can always tap on this manage storage button here and they will be glad to sell you more stuff. See where it says change storage plan? Now, mine is at 50 gigabytes. I have 10 times. And by the way, it's not, here, let me tap on that. It's not expensive. Right? If you want to do it, I'm paying $1 a month for 50 gigabytes of storage space versus 5. And again, that's something that Apple will charge to the credit card that you have on file with your Apple ID. Now you're starting to see how it all comes together here, right? So again, 50, I think that's probably plenty. I don't really, you know, think that I would ever use that many. But if you don't know, this is a good place to find out how much of your stuff is being stored out there in the cloud, okay? And so if we scroll down on this, you can see, here's all the things that are being stored in the cloud on my phone. And first and foremost is, of course, photos. So I have 8.6 gigabytes of photos. If all I had was 5 gigabytes of storage space, I'd have gotten the you're out of storage a long, long time ago, right? So 8 gigabytes of photos, 6.1 gigabytes of backups, which means the phone backs itself up. That's probably going to be the B in iPhone A to Z is going to be backup. So we'll talk about that next week. But other things, notes, books, memos, mail, reminders, there's so much stuff there that stores things on your iCloud drive. Now remember, those are being stored out there in the cloud, okay? So let's back up. Let's top that iCloud on the top. Now here, what I did, by the way, is I went from manage storage. I was on the manage storage button there. Okay, and I went, see where it says iCloud up at the very top, I just tapped on that and it went back to the iCloud settings there. These are all the apps on your phone that are storing their stuff on iCloud. They're borrowing your garage space and your closet space. No. They're supposed to do that, okay? So the first batch of them is all the Apple built-in stuff, like photos and mail, contacts and calendar, reminders and notes, messages, news, stocks. And you can toggle these on or off to decide if that app will store its information in your iCloud account. So, why is this important? If you only have 5 gigabytes of storage space on your iCloud account and you're constantly getting that message, you're out of storage space, you might want to come in here and start turning off some of these things that are storing things in the cloud that you don't need. So like you might look like Game Center. I don't use it. I never have. Why am I storing stuff in Game Center? I don't know. I can turn that off. No big deal, right? Same thing down here, you know, like maps, reminders, shortcuts. Now below that, by the way, are all the other apps on your phone that are storing their stuff in your iCloud account. And there are a bunch, A to Z. Airmail to Zoom, A to Z, literally. And again, this is something that if you're running out of storage space or getting that message that says, hey, you're out of space, all right, you can be turning off some of these things that it's like, I don't even know what Slack is. I can turn that off, you know, or Teams or Trello or Waze or whatever. Is it, you know, if there's some things that you use and need to back up, like if I'm using the Airmail, by the way, is just another email app, all right? So if I'm using that as my primary email app, I might want to back that up because I want to save those emails just in case something happens, right? So again, you can turn all that stuff on or off as you like and save space. Now, again, if you're like me and you have the 50 gigabytes of storage space there, you can see that I'm only using 15 of the 50, even though I have all these guys turned on down here, and some of them I don't even use or care about, but I'm like, I got storage space, you know, coming out of my pockets, so I can afford to, you know, waste a little bit here and there. Your call, all right? If you want to take a ton of pictures and a ton of videos and back up a lot of stuff or whatever, you might want to invest $1 a month in the 50 gigabyte storage space. I'm not telling you to do it or not doing it. I'm just saying that's an option for you as to how you can, you know, get some more storage space for your things on Apple without, you know, having to decide, gee, do I need to keep these pictures or, you know, whatever. So basically that's it for the iCloud part. And I did want to just last, I know this is getting a little long, but hey, it's a classroom after all, right? I did want to go down to the very bottom of the Apple ID page, right? And you can see down there at the bottom where it says iPhone, Bill's Mac, and laptop, right? What if you have other computers or phones or iPads or iWatches that are using the same Apple ID to sign in or to get any kinds of services or whatever, they're going to be listed down there, okay? And that's fine. All that's showing you is that this phone, my Mac computer, my iMac, and my laptop have all at one point or another signed in or used some Apple service that signed in with my iCloud account, right? Now, why is this important? Well, you might see some things down there that you aren't sure where they came from or you don't recognize. Or I used to have 3 phones, but now I only have 1 because I gave the other ones away or sold them or threw them away or something like that, okay? You might want to remove those so they're no longer able to sign into your Apple ID account, to your Apple account. And I'm not going to obviously delete anything, but if I wanted to, for example, I'm going to tap on the Mac there and it's going to get into that. So as you can see, the last thing very bottom there says remove from account. And it even says, if you don't recognize this device, remove it and change your password. Change your Apple ID password is what that's telling you to do, which basically means, hey, maybe somebody logged into your account that you didn't know about, That's kind of important for security, isn't it? Now, of course, mine, I've got my iPhone there, my Mac, and a laptop, and it's a super generic laptop name. I can't change that name. It's a Windows laptop computer, so that's what I get. But at least I know that it's mine, and it's fine, okay? So I know that's a lot, and we didn't cover absolutely everything in here, but at least I think we've covered some of the basics of what there is to know about your Apple ID and how it manages things that are going on your phone or your iPad or your computer. Everybody uses the Apple ID. It's important for everything that you have, and it really just gets to the heart of everything that you do. Let's put it that way, okay? So that's going to do it for today. That was a little long. Thank you for sticking with me on that one. I appreciate it. But in the meantime, if you haven't done so yet, let me invite you over to the website, to BillSkladowski.com. There it is. And I just updated the picture there. I put a big round, a red mark around the click me button there. If you go over to BillSkladowski.com, right? That's, let me bring that up here so you can see it. There it is. There it is. If you go to BillSkladowski.com, once a week we send out an email which has the recap of the videos from the past week. So this was the Wednesday video, this was the Friday video, and then it also has the handout. So as you collect these handouts, hey, in 26 weeks you'll have your iPhone A to Z and you'll have a pretty complete manual there. So I might head over to BillSkladowski.com and sign up for that. In the meantime, just feel free to drop a question or comment or whatever beneath this video, and I will be glad to check into it. If you've got like something that's concerning, or you've got a challenge, or you've been like, I'm trying to figure this thing out now and I still don't know how, drop it in, and maybe it'll be when the letter comes up, we'll get to that. Or it'll be one of our What's New Wednesdays. I like that too. We can cover a lot on the What's New Wednesday. But for now, that's going to do it. Have yourself a safe weekend out there, and we'll see you next week for What's New Wednesday. Thanks. Take care.